Hi everyone, I am Dr. Umameshwar Rao. I have recently started a YouTube channel, Meeru Manam, which means water and why. I have already uploaded few videos and now I am preparing this video, 9 important points to be followed for the success of a borewell or tube well. People, after seeing huge water bodies or reservoirs on the surface of the earth, they are thinking similar water bodies exist below the surface of the earth as underground also. It is not correct. When this earth has formed 4,500 million years back, our crust formed from, solidified from molten magma. It was hard, massive. There were no pores, no water in them. Later on, if we see now our surface of the earth, there is weathered mantle on the top of the earth surface, then some fracture joints are existing, you can see them. How they have formed? Due to continental drifting, the plate movements, the earth's crustal top layers got joints, fractures and weaker zones. Later on, this weathered mantle was formed due to weathering process of water, temperature and air. Around up to 50 meters depth, this weathered mantle is occurring. When rain falls on the surface of the earth, it infiltrates into this weathered mantle, then percolates into the weaker zones, joints, fractures or any other weaker zones, and we are taking out this water only as groundwater. Now we should believe that there is no continuous water body below the surface of the earth. Another misconception, people are saying that the failures of the borewells is only due to rainfall decrease. I too agree that there are rainfall vagaries. Yes, rainfall is the main source of our groundwater, but as you all told, I as a scientist, I cannot say that only due to rainfall vagaries you are facing the problem. I have to give some solution. Keeping this in mind, I have prepared 9 important points. I have categorized them into 9 to give you detailed videos on these 9 points. Now I am giving briefly those 9 points, and later on I will give a detailed videos. My first point is site selection. Many times people are making mistakes in selecting a site. There are few scientific methods. Hydrogeological method is there. Remote sensing maps you can use, and geophysical methods. If we combine the results of all these methods, we will get a better site for drilling a borewell or tube well. Some people follow dowsing methods. I may not believe, but some people say that we don't have any access to all these methods. So I will give how to go for a site to drill borewell or tube well when you don't have any methods also in my detailed video. Second point, I consider rig selection, distance, depth and budget. If you go to a good rig gentleman, he will guide you in a better way. Similarly, you should not attempt to drill a borewell when there is a successful borewell nearby you. There should be minimum distance. You should follow minimum distance. Then depth. Generally, people are attempting to drill more and more depths, but it is not correct. These joints, fractures or weaker zones, they will decrease with the depth. Only top 100 meter, we have more disturbance, more joints, more fractures. And if you go beyond that, it will decrease. So you have to stick for your depth of the borewell. then budget, depending on depth and rig gentleman's quote, you can calculate your budget and you can prepare, you can be prepared for that budget. Then third point I consider as casing pipe. Many times we are making mistakes in lowering the casing pipe. In hard rock areas, up to loose formation, we will lower the casing pipe. In soft rock areas or sedimentary rocks, we lower entire depth of the borehole. So while lowering this casing, while selecting the pipes, you have to be very careful. Then zones, we have to note down the zones. Again, in sedimentary rocks, against the zones, you have to keep slotted pipes. Exactly where the zones are there, they are slotted pipes. Other areas, it should be blank. In such cases also, we should be very careful. Then closing up borewell. We have to close the borewell up to the required depth only. Then fourth point, I considered completion of borewell tube well. After drilling, people think that it is over, but no, there is completion of borewell. It includes development. Yes, we have to develop the borewell. We have to clean it for its drill cuttings, clay and other things. We have to get fresh water out of that. We have to run for hours. Then discharge, we have to measure the discharge of the borewell or tube well. Then fluctuation, what is fluctuation? Water level in the beginning and run it for 4 or 5 hours or 6 hours, whatever time you want. Then you take water level. The difference between initial and last water level is fluctuation. You should know this also. Then water quality, you have to take a sample and get it analyzed. That is also required. Next point I consider as pump selection. It's HP, depending on your discharge and depth of the borewell, you have to select a pump and you have to lower it depending on your zones. Then sixth point I consider as surroundings of the borewell. Yes, the borehole and casing pipe, in between them there is small gap. We should not allow water infiltrate into the borewell through this gap. We have to close it. We have to grout it. It is called as grouting, with the clay or cement. Totally, there should not be any drainages nearby the borewell or tube well. And also trees, sometimes trees, roots of the trees are affecting our borewells. So the surroundings of the borewell should be clean. Next, seventh point I consider as artificial recharge and conservation. Yes, in earlier days we used to say conserve and artificial. Now it has become artificial recharge first, then all you have to con. It has become more important. Why? Because of our concretization, our urbanization and other process, our recharge has decreased, and now we have to go for artificial recharge, compulsory. We made it compulsory because our recharge has decreased, coupled with our discharges have increased. So it has become necessary. There are so many methods. I will deal in my detailed videos what are the different methods to follow. Then conservation. Yes, conservation. We have to adopt modern techniques for irrigation and for households also. Through them, we have to minimize our consumption. We have to use whatever available, we have to use that water. Then management. Yes, we are failing many times in the management of borehole or tube well. We should have some pumping plans for a day and a month or a year. Yes, sometimes rainfall is droughts are coming, sometimes rainfall is decreasing in some year and increasing in some years. So same pumping plan should not run. We have to make our own plans and implement, then only we will succeed. So the borewell management also very, very important. In my detailed video I will cover how to manage our borewells. Then maintenance of, last point, ninth point is maintenance of borewell. Yes, people drill the borewell or tube well and forget about that. Use it. There is no maintenance. Whereas in other instruments in our house, we are getting them serviced periodically. But why not for borewell? We have to maintain it, we have to service it, we have to flush it, we have to clean our pumps periodically. Then only our borewells or tubewells will give you good results. With this, I will close my this video, and I will give all my detailed videos on all my 9 points, all these 9 points. You please see my videos, share to your friends and other people, subscribe my channel for getting all these 9 videos without any break. So with these few remarks, I will close my video here itself. Namaste. Thank you very much for viewing my video. Bye.